It's the love. Welcome back. She is the classically trained powerhouse who blends opera, folk, pop and musical theatre with ease. We are, of course, talking about the spectacular Kate Miller-Heidke. Called out to the stars, wished for you to cry.
Timeless, is it just
she's
me?
Amazing.
And she's returning to the stage touring her fifth studio album, Child in Reverse. And she joins us now from Melbourne this morning. Kate, great to see you.
Morning. Great to see you guys. Thanks for having me.
I mean, how good is it now that touring's back? We're seeing so many artists like yourself getting back out on the road again. It must feel good.
It really does. It just fills me with so much hope to see our industry bursting back to life. And this tour in particular has been delayed and rescheduled countless times. It was meant to happen in 2020. And I put this record out in 2020 and I haven't really had a chance to play these songs to people, to real live 3D people. And I'm just so looking forward to it.
We miss the 3D, don't we? Yeah. As we touched on, you have this amazing knack for blending just about every kind of genre of music and doing it in such a beautiful way. What can audiences expect from this tour and this new sound?
Look, it's just been such a hard couple of years. This tour is just going to be a celebration. It's going to be, you know, a bit of everything. We're taking requests. Hit me up on Instagram or Facebook if you've got a song you want to hear. We're going to do some covers. A lot of people have been requesting Kate Bush,
yeah.
So that might have to make an appearance. New stuff, old stuff, some surprises. I'm going to keep it super kind of super casual.
Well, I mean, obviously they're going to ask for Kate Bush. You did that incredible version of Wuthering Heights a few years back. And there it is there.
Yeah.
And of course, with Running Up That Hill, Deal With God back on the charts right around the world. I mean, is she someone that was an influence on you growing up? Because the styles, you both have extraordinary styles and they're very similar.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, look, she was an influence, and a lot of people that were influenced by her were influences, Tori Amos being a massive one.
Yes.
For me. So I think her influence on, you know, every piece of music that came after her was massive. You know, she really permeated that, the culture in a lot of ways.
Do you love that we're revisiting these albums, these musicians of sort of decades ago and the nostalgia that comes with that?
Yeah, well, when it comes to Kate Bush, yes. totally. I mean, she deserves it, and it's, you know, back catalogue is just a treasure trove, and it's so cool to think of teenagers, you know, all the delights that they have in store.
I mean, look, I know you're touring and you know, you're back on the road and that'll mean you're very busy, but you're such an incredible writer as well of musicals. I mean, Muriel's Wedding was such a huge success. Is there any more on the stove for you? What else are you cooking up there?
Oh, thanks. Yeah, got a couple of things simmering away. Nothing I can really talk too much about yet, but straight after this tour, we are going to New York. We've got a big lab on Broadway for Muriel's Wedding.
Ooh,
so
wow.
Looking to open that show over in the States, which is really exciting.
That's incredible,
that's
Kate.
Awesome.
That's amazing.
Well, when you are allowed to talk about those next things, you make sure you come back to us as soon as you can.
Totally.
So we can chat again.
I'd love that.
Congrats on all the success you're having and thanks so much for joining us this morning.
Such a pleasure. Thanks, guys.
Thanks,
our pleasure. And for tickets to Kate's concert, Child in Reverse, visit frontiertouring.com.au. She is such a supreme talent, isn't she? Stay with us when we return the latest Nine News headlines.